One of the other beautiful features that we've got here at Sidmouth is this fantastic limestone. It was felt really important to try and select the right kind of stone, the right colours to fit in with the local environment. Sidmouth itself has lots of beautiful stone on the beach, and so the selection of stone was key.
So the steps and many of the features we've made from Carlow Blue limestone, which contrasts with some of the other stones we've got. It's a very hard stone, and the benefit of it is you can engrave and add texture to the stone, which provides a contrasting finish. So you see the front edge of each stone is a lighter finish. So visually, you can see the front edge of that stone. We haven't had to sort of paint anything on or inset a different colour stone into the step. But it ties in nicely with the stone we've used on the main retaining wall, which is also a limestone, but that's a two-tone of grey limestone. So, you know, we've got a cohesive palette of materials in terms of appearance. So the stone we've used for the cladding on the retaining wall and the cladding of the head wall, that's sourced from Lantoon Quarry, which is a quarry not far from here. So it's locally sourced material. And that had to go through the planning approval process. And we've ensured there's a colour mix so that it's not just a consistent flat colour of stone.
So now we're in the centre of the amphitheatre, and what we have here is this central flow control chamber. What it is it's surrounded by some beautiful limestone, engraved limestone, and on that we've got a poem that's telling the story of a tree's seed, Mr. Monterey. So Mr. Monterey is actually one of the Monterey pines actually within the Sidmouth Amphitheatre, and it's the name that's been given to it.
So it was a colleague of mine that penned the poem that runs around the central stones there, but that pays reference to one of the trees that's further back in the site, a Monterey pine tree, which is a huge old tree. And she came up with the idea that that the trees talk to one another, and Monty, being the Monterey pine tree, has travelled far and sown its seeds within the site. So that's the history of the poem.
Okay, so what we can see, beautiful oolites embedded within the limestone. Effectively, there's fossils, as we can see, spread around all of these pieces of limestone. But in the centre of this, what we wanted to do, we wanted to make a real feature of this. So this wasn't just about the fact that it has a water function, which it does, but we also wanted to make it artistic. So it actually fitted there and looked nice and added to the overall design. So our landscape architect came up with a beautiful pattern to try and mimic leaves. Those leaves in there are actually being cut out. So there's holes through the centre of this lid. That's to allow the water to percolate into this chamber underneath. But also, as the water builds up below ground within the tank, what we'll find is there's air being trapped. So as that air is being pushed up, it's allowed back out to the surface through this as a vent. So it allows water in, but it also allows air out. The other thing that this chamber does, because we're in the middle of a parkland here, there's obviously a real risk should this lid either be lifted up by the water or be removed by some unscrupulous character, that there could be a risk or a hazard to people and the public. So we had to make sure that it was secure and couldn't be removed unless it was being removed by someone who knew what they were doing. So there's a special locking mechanism in place. In addition to that locking mechanism, we also thought that it would be a smart move to try and minimize the risk of any one person having to operate this on their own. This is quite a large and heavy cover. So we thought about ways in which we could do that. So the actual design now is a lockable lid. But once that's unlocked, it actually rises under a spring-loaded strut that's actually placed below the ground to lift that clear and allow it to be easily spun out of the way for maintenance purposes. That can be done by one person safely. And then there is no risk of that being able to be stolen, because not only is it lockable, but also it's actually bolted to the spring on the inside of the chamber, so it can't then be removed. So there's no way it could be accidentally left out of position. So this is safe on a number of levels, as well as being an attractive solution.